Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, guys, we are looking at Calendars 5, which is an iOS application that you can use for managing calendar events and tasks. So we're going to be diving into it today, so let's jump in. So guys, naturally I have the iOS version in front of me. I want to give you a bit of a tour of it today. Some of the things I'll mention is I'm going to break this into two parts. We're going to do a quick review of some of the brand new features, which are a minor sort of navigational features and a few sort of additions that I know a lot of Calendars 5 people will love. And then I'm going to dive into the resource as a whole because I know a lot of people considering calendar applications like this. So we're going to be diving in and talking about that near the end. Just before we dive in, a big thank you to Missive for sponsoring this month here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Missive is a team collaboration tool. I include it in description along with my review. And also, I will talk about it a little later in this video. So guys, here we are with Calendars 5. This had an iOS update, I believe, the other day. So if you're looking for it, you probably have to go to the App Store, press the update button, and everything will be changed. So the first thing you'll notice is it now has a fixed bar at the top. So instead of before having to tap something and then go up to the actual views option of tasks, list, day, week, month, you can now just have it all fixed, which is great. So if you want to switch between the day view and the week view, it's perfect. So if I want to go ahead and add an entry, I just have to drag my thumb down and I can use the language input to add anything. So for example, like, film YouTube video. And you can see that it obviously adds that there. And of course, because I've added a date, I go ahead and save it and it will be added to my calendar. So nothing's changed in terms of design of the day view, but you can switch between stuff really easily now, and that's one of the great things. Of course, you still have the task area, which is a good experience, but on this left-hand side, you have a new navigation area, which allows you to switch between your different calendars, switch some of them off, switch some of them on, which is so much easier than last time. You can go ahead and edit them at the bottom. So for example, if I wanted to edit the calendars I had or add an additional one, I can easily do so. Now, a new area at the top is called search. You can now go ahead and search a specific keyword. So for example, if I search something like haircut, I can see all of the last haircuts that I've had over the last couple of months. So it's quite a useful way in being able to search for pieces that you've added, meetings that you've got coming up, and even family events that you want to plan. So all of these are new additions, the ability to see the new pinned, the actual ability to change the views fast, the new navigation on the left-hand side, combined with the search, makes it so much easier to be able to manage Calendars 5. So let's dive into Calendars 5 as a whole. So this is Calendars 5 in front of me. It's available on iOS. It's not available on web, or it's not available on Android. Neither it is available on Mac, but it makes a really strong calendar experience. And the reasons why is because it's got a really robust experience. This is created by Reinier, which is a company that develops Spark, really strong PDF application, and so much more. And they're a great company for that. So you can see here that you've got task, list, day, week, and month view. And people love having all of these options. And what I particularly like is the day view as well as the scheduled agenda view. It seems to work really well. If you already have tasks associated, for example, to your Google Tasks and you've connected up with your Google Calendar, then they will be imported automatically. And the great thing is, if I go to tasks, I can actually see them in there too. So, for example, if I want to have a little task manager in there, although I don't recommend it, if you wanted to, you could have a little task or to-do list application in there. You could even go ahead and create new lists, but it will link up with your Google Tasks, which is a good experience. Now, one of my favorite features is the ability to, as I showed you a moment ago, be able to push on the day view and actually set a short meeting or anything. And that's quite useful. But one of the things that I know a lot of people love is going to the top right hand corner and being able to use the natural language input. So, for example, say plan my day tomorrow at, for example, 3 p.m. It will automatically detect all that stuff, throw it in, and then I can add all of the relevant stuff. I can add location, whether it's a repeat, any notes as well. And as you can see here, it's gone straight in. What I love as well is when you tap it, it doesn't bring up a whole page. You've got this lovely preview window. And if I wanted to go ahead and delete it, I could do that from not even moving out of that page. So it's a lovely, almost desktop-like experience. So a couple of other things that I really love about this application is that you can scrubble between the weeks at the bottom. If I want to go far ahead, I can easily do that with a quick swipe, and it's a great addition to that. Now, one of the things I'd say is it's perfect for iOS users, those who use Google Calendar, but you're really going to struggle if you want to access it on other devices. At the moment, I currently use an application called TimePage, which, in my opinion, has gotten so much better. And as you can see here, it's got a bunch of gestures. I can pop into the day views, and I can go into all of my layouts. And what I quite like is being able to actually add stuff. I'm going to do a full feature on TimePage. I've done a review of it, but I'll do an updated feature soon. So guys, Calendars 5 is great for if you want a reliable Google Tasks, Google Calendar application for iOS that has a robust list viewing option and is reliable. I highly recommend this application if you're looking for that. But before we go, guys, I wanted to mention Missive. Missive is March 2019 sponsor here on Keep Productive. They have a great team collaboration email tool, which allows you to, for example, if you want to assign an email to someone else to write in your team, you can do so. You can chat in rooms, you can assign tasks to each other, you can collaborate in real time over drafts, and you can do so much more, including all of the advanced email abilities like read receipts, send later, rules, automation, APIs. It works really well, and I use it as my own email tool. So I highly recommend it. So guys, do check it out in the description below. Big thank you to those guys. Hope you like Calendars 5. Do check it out in the description below again too. Feel free to comment with some of your own experiences with calendar applications. And I will see you guys very, very soon, guys. Cheers.